little bit. No. No, a little bit. Come here. Come here. Come on. Where are you going? What are you doing? What's going on with you? Ah! What's up, Chris? I'll see you later. Thanks for stopping by. Ali song, hand transfer, which one? Do I do it? That one? That one? Which one? Tell me. I'll show you. I'll break it down. I haven't done any workshops, eh? It's been a minute. What's up, Joel? How you doing? What's going on with you? Turn your hands like overlap, quick pass. Oh. Right. Is that a new trick? Is that gonna be in Beglery Beglery? I'm looking forward to that, Simon. Have you already uploaded it, the new one? I'm addicted to your frequent reports on Beglery. Yeah? You're like the anchor man of Beglery. That's cool. Someone had to do it. Oh, I gotta keep an eye for that one. You're gonna have to tag me or whatever. I've been pissing off the Dali song people a little bit. Just a little bit. Because I've been posting up flip fins on Reddit. It's weird because the first clip got a lot of hate, pretty much. I mean, maybe not too bad, but enough where a couple people said, delete this. This is horrible. I think somebody said that. I'm not sure. Then I got a lot of love because you know how they are. Dali song people are real, they don't mess around, they don't want to see toys. Maybe they feel threatened by that. I don't know. But I thought I was doing pretty good. I think I have been improving on it. You saw it, right? You've seen the flip fins. Yeah, they do. They look silly. I'm gonna get another one. Wait. I don't know if you've noticed, but the one that I have, only one light lights. I broke the other two. Sadness, right? Oh my god, sadness. I'm trying to get better with this, just for the fun of it. But then everybody like gets pissed off. Not everybody, but some people do. And for some reason, shout out to Mitch. Because he brought up Bali one of the last streams he did, and he asked me if I was in this Facebook group of Bali, and I was invited to join it. So I submitted it's one of those groups where you have to answer questions or something. Like they want to know if you're worthy to be in the group. I was like, you know, I forgot about that kind of stuff, that it's still a thing. There's still groups out there that are kind of inclusive, I guess is the word. How do you say when they only elitist? They only want certain people in it and they won't let anybody else in the group. And if you're not worthy, you don't get in or something like that. I didn't know that that was still a thing. I haven't really been in other groups other than the ones, you know, that I'm already in. This one and a couple of others, but I'm more active here. And everybody here is really cool. Like I don't ever, you know, I forgot about that aspect of skill toys and how some people in particular just are rude to others for whatever reason. Well, anyway, they won't let me in that group. And I think it was because I didn't answer all the questions. Yeah, it is wide. If I get my regular one, you see how wide it is? It's huge. But that doesn't mean that it can't be used. You know, like I've been trying to mess with it. There's things you could do with it. I see potential in all things, actually. So I don't hate on any toy. Yeah, there is. So yeah, Mitch, I can't get in that group, so, you know, I thought I was in it, but I'm not. In the Valley group, they won't let me in. Maybe they've looked me up and they say, oh no, not her. She doesn't play with real ones. She plays with this and then she plays with clones. No, let's not let her in. It could be. I mean, I don't know. I don't know how they do their thing. But, no love for me in Bali. Except for Reddit. Reddit's been pretty nice to me. For the most part. I was expecting a lot more hate. Yeah, they do. What is it with the drama? I'm at the age where I avoid drama. I really do. Because I think it's silly and stupid. It's not worth my time. I'm too old for that. That's like high school shit. And back in high school, I've probably had drama with one good friend. And she, like, unfriended me in real life because I was friends with somebody she didn't like, or she had a falling out with them, so then she cut me out, too. It was, like, real stupid. Then I connected with her later in life, like, I want to say, I don't know, 5 years ago or something. And she acted all nice and stuff, but then apparently she got pissed off by something a comment I put on one of her pictures on Facebook. I thought we were good. I thought it was all good. I didn't expect her to still have drama. And she had drama with me again. So those people like never seem to ever grow out of that drama thing. Sad. In real life, unfriending, yeah. It happened to me. I was devastated. I was like, wait a minute, we just reconnected. Like, I thought we were friends again. Like, we even said our, you know, I'm sorry, it didn't mean to to not be your friend, and we were best friends, and blah, blah, blah. And then, like I said, I thought I was being funny, okay? She apparently thought she was a model at home, in her living room. Like, she wasn't a real model. I think she worked at Toys R Us. But why I say this is because she would have her kids take seductive pictures of her. I didn't think it was cool. I mean, she was my age, and she was like sprawled out on the living room floor in sexy situations, and I'm like, who took that picture? It was her daughter that took the picture. Her daughter is a little teenager, like a preteen. I was like, yeah, that's not cool, man. And my comment was, I had messaged her, but she wouldn't reply to my message, so I just dropped a comment on her picture, and I was like, yeah, when you're done with your modeling session, can you check your messages, because I sent you something. I thought it was funny, but she didn't. So she just unfriended me on Facebook. And I'm like, again? First in real life in the ninth grade, and now she did it again. So I was just like, whatever. I'm too old for this shit. I'm not even gonna care. So I have that mentality. I'm an older person, yeah? I come from an older generation. Drama is not my bag. And when I see drama happening online, I just laugh at it. Like, I don't even really engage. That should be the advice to all of you young people out there. If you see drama, someone's like, you know, trying to get you to engage in an argument that can be ongoing and just be super ridiculous and embarrassing for everyone involved, especially like on Facebook in groups and such. You can see all that. Everyone can read it. It's just embarrassing and stupid. It's a waste of energy. Yeah. Paint me like your French women, Jack. Draw me like your French girls. And she was just like, oh, like, I don't even want to show you how she did it. Yeah, it was kind of silly. Hey, Clyde. What you doing, Clyde? Clyde, you're becoming a legend, okay? So you better keep making videos. I'm telling you from my heart. Keep doing what you're doing, because you're becoming a legend. People are watching you, dude. Like me. So yeah, my advice for all the drama that happens and stuff, ignore it, walk away, don't even engage. They can't fight by themselves. It takes two to tango. So if you just let them say whatever and not let it hurt your emotions, or everybody just gets too emotional these days. I don't know. The internet has done strange things to society as far as mentality, like how people read into messages. They read things that are not there. They get hostile. You know, it's a thing. And it's a sad thing. Especially when there's really no animosity going on, but someone reads it incorrectly and they just assume that you know, there's a combat about to happen, and they gotta get into fight mode, and they want to fight. Yeah, Clyde, we're watching you, and you rock. So you keep doing what you're doing, because we want to see more. Okay, we love your journey, even though if you're still a beginner and you're still learning, that's a part of it, and we want to see it. So Clyde, keep rocking, man. Keep rocking. Yeah, you are getting better. That's the whole point of it. It's like anything. Anything that you have a passion for, you know, could be any hobby at all. We don't all start off wonderful and like at the top level. There's some people that are talented and they have like a really, really small learning curve. It's like, boom, from, you know, 1 to 3 days pass, and they're already doing things that we're still working on. we haven't gotten down in years, you know, me in particular. So just don't even worry about any of that. I love to see everybody learn. Yeah, you do, Mitch. You have a passion for sarcasm. Mitch, you're funny. Sometimes I don't know if you're joking. You have a, what do they call that? Dry humor. But I dig it. I like it. I was just sometimes, you know, I have to ask, are you kidding? Are you joking? But I know it's all good. You're my brother from another mother, man. You know what I mean? You feel me? You picking up what I'm putting down? It's all for you, dude. Brothers for life. Bros before hoes. Oh, that doesn't sound right, but I don't care. I'm an older person, and I don't care how I sound. When I used to do the art walks and play my Nintendo music on the street corner, I would dance all crazy, right? And my coworkers saw some of those videos, and they were like, ugh, you jump around all weird. Like, why do you do that? Don't you care that people are looking at you? And I'm like, no, I just don't care. I just move around because I'm alive. You know, I went through all the bullshit of like, oh wait. I went through all the bullshit of high school and growing up and college, and I never went through some of the stuff that a lot of people went through, that, you know, trying to find themselves in the early 20s. You know how that was a thing? I never went through that. I always knew who I was. I guess some people don't know who they are, and they have to find themselves. So, what was I going to say? What was I saying? Before I distracted myself. Oh yeah, I didn't care. I would just dance crazy. I didn't care if people were watching me, or if they were laughing at me, or what they thought of me. You know, I would do art walks. I would, every first Friday of every month, the music, all the local musicians would be designated a street corner where they were allowed to play their live music, you know? And while me and a friend of mine that I used to play this underground club with, he played noise, I included him, and I was like, let's go do this, but let's make them renegade shows. So we had no permission. We didn't get a permit. We weren't even supposed to be there, but we would plug into an outlet that was on the one street corner that nobody wanted, because all the bums would hang out there. And it was right across from the bus station. It was fun times, man. And so I did that for a year, just to see if I could do it. And it was kind of hard, because I would go right after work and I'd drink like 2 monster drinks just to stay energized. Because, you know, after 8-hour days of work, and on a Friday, you don't want to stand around from 6 p.m. to 10, which is what, 4 hours, right? Is that what it is? 5 hours or something? After you've been at work for 8, it's not a normal thing. Nobody wants to do that. No, dude, I played music. I played my Nintendo. We had a speaker, and we'd blast it, and we had, like, this concrete wall right behind us, yeah? And it was a trip, because the concrete wall apparently made the volume louder. Like, it it just blasted it louder because it would bounce off of, the sound bounced off the wall, and then it would push it across the street, and nobody liked what we were doing because we were making noise with Game Boys. But it was fun. I got into it because I really liked the music you could create with a Game Boy, a Nintendo DS. I still do it, I just don't do it as often. And yeah, when we did the art walks, I would support my fellow players that I would bring in, right? I would organize this shit all the time. So I would hunt out other young aspiring Game Boy kids, because they were all teenagers that would do it. And I would tell them, hey, come on, we have a street corner, you know, come to our corner. You can play with us. We have, you know, an amp and all. And when they would play, I would dance for them, all stupid, while they were playing. And all their friends, you know, from school and stuff would show up, and they would be out there dancing too. But like, my whole point is, I didn't care if they were looking at me and laughing and saying, ah, look at her, she's dancing stupid. Like, I didn't care. I'm too old to care. Ain't nobody got time for that. Yeah, man, do your thing and don't care what people think. I don't know why everybody gets self-conscious. I mean, look, I do live streams. Do you think that I do this because I care what people think? You know, I don't get embarrassed. I'm like the last person to care what other people think of me. Which is why I'll do like crazy toys that nobody really wants to play with, or they're embarrassed to show others. You go, oh man, I play with hardcore ballets, but I'm never gonna play with a toy. I'm too cool for that. That'll ruin my street cred. What? Have fun with everything. Life's too short. Why do you care? That's how I feel. That's the way I live my life. So yeah, keep rocking, man. Do everything you want to do and don't care what people think about you. They don't pay your bills. I don't want to know what you think of me, Mitch. Is that for real? Are you being for real? Come on now. I am. It's true. I'm the first to admit it. I'm a weirdo. And boy, do I have fun. Ah, now that I got that out of the way. Oh yeah, your level of care goes down. I was talking to a friend of mine who, how old is he? He's 30. I think he's about 10 years younger than me or something. And he was like, he was commenting and talking on his wall and saying things like, or to friends, I don't remember where he said it, on Discord. He was saying, oh man, now that I'm older, I just don't understand all these, society is different now, and I feel old now because of it, you know, because people, like, basically he was saying people have become more stupid. And maybe that, you know, intelligence levels have gone down as technology has gone up, because right now we're at a point where a smartphone will do so many things for you that, you know, you never thought could happen. For example, at work, I work with AutoCAD. 2017, we just upgraded to 2018. And it's like, the more advanced a program gets, or technology for that matter, it becomes easier for people with less knowledge to use it. I guess it's more user-friendly each time. But by doing that, they're dumbifying the ones that went to school and got an education to learn how to use a program. Because now it's even easier to use, and it makes it even harder to do simple things. That's my experience. Oh, I hate it. I hate technology. I hate how it's always advancing, but can't it just stay still just for a little while? You know, that's my only grievance. What band am I listening to? Oh, I hope they don't ban me for this. I just found some non-copyright heavy metal. I'm playing that right now from YouTube. It sounds good. I like it. That's another thing. Rock has really gone downhill. But this sounds really good, so. Ha ha. Rock has turned too poppy, I think. But, you know, so is life. Nothing stays the same. I'm an Iron Maiden girl. I used to listen to Faith No More and other weird stuff. At the drive-in in Sparta, that was like my more recent metal or alternative rock type of music. Oh, thank you, Clyde. Oh, later, Mitch. You're gonna go. You're not gonna stay and laugh at me some more. Give me more laughs. One more laugh before you leave, please. I want to see the little happy, laughy face. One more. Yes? No? Somebody? Anybody? Oh, don't be shy. I think he's gone. What time is it? How? I hit the forearm bone. I'm not expecting to do that. What happened to me? How did I let this happen to me? Hey, Simon, are you still there? Can you do this one? Can you do this one? I'll break it down. Do an upswing and you catch it here. Here's where I like to catch it, right here. So yeah, I'll catch it here, outside, standard, high grip. Or no, not standard, I guess it's outside. High grip, first off. Then I release it, swing it this way so that it rebounds off the top of my hand. Then I swing it back to the other hand and do it the other way, this way, okay? So the other hand goes like this, swings that way, comes back around. I don't know what that's called. Are those the weenies? The green string. Okay, wait. This one? No. That's green. I have too much light. Maybe that's why. Yeah, you're right. The green looks good. I'm always having trouble finding out which sets to sling with because of my lighting situation, and it's all dark in my house. I live like a vampire. All the windows are boarded up and covered. I let no light in. No light touches this skin unless I go outside. Okay, you can do that one. Okay, let me show you something else I can do that I've been doing that you can probably do. Let me see. Oh, I saw somebody else doing this, so I kind of cheated, kind of copied their thing. Oh, remember to do everything you can do, Simon. Never forget. Don't be short-term. Look at me. I'm short-term. I had a concussion back in... I can't even remember. Back in 2000, I was in a car wreck with my boyfriend, and we were going up the freeway after a night of clubbing. We didn't club. We just went to this blues bar that we used to go to. And anyway, we were coming home. A drunk driver was going to go up the freeway the wrong way. And I just remember we were stopped at the stoplight, and that's all I remember. But he hit us. Boom. And I had, like, my head was, like, way out here. Like, it was crazy, dude. So since then, I forget stuff a lot. Only certain things, though, not everything. Yeah, it's because I have this black background. If I use different colors, it's kind of hard to see them, I find. Especially, you know, the sets. If I have colored sets, you may not see them as well because of this black background. So I'm still trying to struggle with what sets I should use. Oh, so where was I before I get off? Because I'm kind of over my time. I was going to show you this one. Did you see that? Did you see what I did? I'll do it in front way. In frontal vision. Oh, wait. Okay. Did you see that? Did you see that, Simon? Let me see it again. Okay, this is, I put my two thumbs together. I come this way. I do a roll. I guess a rolling stop. Like that. Then I turn this hand like that, which is where I'm doing a rebound here, forward. Yeah. I tend to put myself in strange, I set myself up a lot when I'm saying stuff. Yeah, so I saw someone do it with each finger on Instagram. They did it with each finger. Let's see, wait. So they went index, roll, back. I haven't been practicing that. I only did the thumb because I can do the thumb easier. That's the one that I did. I didn't see him do the thumb, and I said, oh, I can do that. I'm like Barry Manilow. I like to look at Instagram clips, and if I see something, I won't necessarily steal it, but I'll incorporate it in what I do in a different way. And I hear tell Barry Manilow used to do that a lot. He would go on YouTube and listen to original songs that people would put up, and kind of rip them off. I don't know if it was Brax. It might have been. I just saw like each finger. Yeah, it might have been him. And I was like, wow, that's cool. I never thought of doing, because I'm always doing two-handed stuff. So I thought, oh, that's cool. Like if I work on it, I can probably do all the fingers. But for now, I was just like, oh, I can do the thumb easy. I don't even have to think about that one. The thumb is golden, man. You never go wrong with the thumb. Oh, I just went wrong with it. I spoke too soon. Wait. Oh, did I jump? My internet sucks. Let's see if I can do it on this way. Ah. Messy. There you go. Second tee. Second try. Yeah, he does it differently. I just saw how he did it, and I was like, I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna do it the way I do it. I do that a lot. Like, if I see Liam, for example, you know Kids Rock, he does crazy shit, and I can't duplicate the stuff he does. I really can't. I try. There's a lot of things I just can't do. He's at such a level that there's no way I can ever reach him for some reason. But there's things that I can do that he doesn't do. Like this, let me see. I did this. I was like, can you do this? He was like, what the hell was that? So yeah, that's another thing. I need to do a tutorial for this. I know. Oh, here it is. I'll show you with this one, because you can see it with this one better. Oh! I faked the ending there. Oh, your thumbs hurt. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll do some tutorials, right? Should I? I think I will. Because it's about time I do them. I've been asked to do them for Monkey Knuckles. And I said like a year ago, maybe 2 years now, that I was gonna do some, and I never got around to it. I feel so bad. But I totally need to do them for, at least for Beggary, because I do a lot of cool stuff that nobody else does. Like all that, to see all this. Oh, what? Oh my goodness, what? Let's see. I don't know how you do your mic drops with these, because I just can't seem to. I saw what you tried to do in the copycat. It was kind of like you held it upward like this, and then you went that way, playing backwards. And somebody said, yeah, that's not a mic drop. I think it was Phil. Phil is our stickler for that trick is not done properly. You need to redo it. It's just helpful. It's good to know if you're not doing it right. But I thought that was kind of inventive, because I can't see a different way you can do it with thumb chucks, because you can't really get that tension and get around your fingers with the size of the ball. Like I tried to do my three-finger mic drop that I do, where I wrap it around three fingers and then I go like this and spread them apart, but I can't seem to catch it. It doesn't do what all my other sets do because of the size. So yeah, it doesn't really want to. This one doesn't work on thumb chucks for me. It just does. Now I can do it with something like this. There you go. And get closer. Yeah. There. I can do that. I just can't do it with thumb chucks. It's weird. Okay, that's my time. I think I have overstayed my visit. But keep on watching. If there's streamers, keep streaming. New streamers, if you're watching and you've never streamed before, go for it, man. Don't even be shy. I did a whole, the lesson you learned from my stream today was don't be shy. Just keep doing what you're doing. Don't care what other people think, because it's all a learning process anyway. And you might be doing something that other people haven't thought of. You might be doing it incorrectly and someone else can help you. You know, so never feel ashamed or embarrassed or anything to show your progress or to stream live. That's why we're here, man. That's why Saturdays are fun and cool. So we get to stream live with each other. So have a good weekend. Have a good Saturday.